worshiping one deity. He's not like someone that is worshiping many deities. As Allah mentioned in Surah Zumar. That one that is worshiping one deity is not like, right? Abdan Mamlukan, a servant that is owned by one, is not like a servant that is owned by many, many owners. That everybody has a right to in regard to them. So therefore he will have this, in Shirah al-Sadr, he will have this widening of his chest in because of the Tawheed of Allah. But also from the virtue of the Tawheed in his life, it is that it will make your blood sacred. Alaysa kadhalik? It will make your wealth sacred. Right? So this is from, barakallahu fikum, the virtue of the Tawheed in this life. And as all of these things that we mentioned, barakallahu fikum, from entering the Jannah, from free being, not to be in the hellfire forever, and alhamdulillah, and all alone with those issues that are from the greatness of the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all the prophets that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ever sent, they all, barakallahu fikum, put the emphasis in the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of the prophets that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent, they all put a stretch mark in what? In regard to the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So likewise, the Da'watul Anbiya, as you look at the book, barakallahu fikum, Manhajul Anbiya, ايش؟ في دعوة إلى الله. Manhaj al-Anbiya fi da'wat ila Allah. Na'am, that's the name of the book by Shaykh Rabi Hafidhahullah. A very nice book. You know, really we enjoin the advise the brothers if they can have a hold of that book. Alhamdulillah, benefit from it. And you will see what was the methodology of the prophets. The methodology was the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ulama also, they mentioned, like Imam al-Sa'idi rahimahullah, he said the first command that Allah commanded in the Quran from when you open the Mus'haf, it is, Ya ayyuhal nas, u'budu rabbakum. U'budu rabbakum, O you people, worship your Lord. And now he mentioned those things that is making Allah al-mustahiq lil-ibad. Those things that is making Allah the one that is deserving to be worshipped alone. Alladhi ja'ala lakum al-arda firashan. Was-sama'a bina'a. وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم. All of these things, Imam al-Sa'di, he said, the one that did all of this, he is truly the only one deserving to be worshipped. And walhamdulillah, akhi, this verse alone, if we are talking and conveying Islam to the disbelievers, this verse alone is enough. Because no one on the face of the earth is entitled for such actions. They will tell you alone that Jesus cannot send the rain down. They will tell you right away that Jesus cannot bring the vegetation forth. They will tell you that, barakallahu fikum, that who is the one that set the heavens as the canopy and making the earth, barakallahu fikum, like a bed. Nobody can do that, barakallahu fikum, but Rabbu samawati wa ard, but the Lord, the creator of the heavens and the earth. So therefore, he is the only one deserving to be worshipped. Tayyib. Shaykh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, Tamimi, he mentioned in the verse in Surah Al-Dhariyat, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, he say, إِلَّا لِيُوَحِّدُونَ, except that they single me out. إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, meaning, except they worship me, but he mentioned, it means except that they single me out in worship. So the issue of Tawheed, barakallahu fikum, and the issue of shirk, you will not open the Mus'haf and not read about it in any other in a page. You cannot open a page and not read the issues of shirk and issue of at-Tawheed. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said that the Quran deal with three matters. First of all, at-Tawheed, and the matters of the qasa'is, the narratives, and the third matter of the sharia, yes, the matters, the rules and regulation. But he say in actuality, all of those three things revolve back to the Tawheed of Allah. Because the issues of the narratives, It is talk, and Sheikh Rabi Hafidhullah brought this in his book, The Manhajul Anbiya. He mentioned in this that the issues of the qasais, meaning the rhetoric or the narratives, it is telling us about the previous nations, how either they were rebellious against the prophets, or how they were obedient to the prophets, alayhimu salatu wassalam. For those who were rebellious against them, how they were in against the line of tawheed, how Allah destroyed them. And for those who were in line with the obedience to the prophets, in line with the tawheed, how Allah akramahum bil jannah, how Allah has honored them with the paradise. So in reality, the matters of the narratives in the Quran, it is boiling down in regard to the tawheed of Allah. Likewise, the affairs of the sharia. When we're fasting, who are we fasting for? When we're praying, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. It is not for no one but for Allah. Isn't that the tawheed? So therefore the whole of the Quran is a matter of tawheed. This is why وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ وَالْمِنْ. When we read the Quran, then if we don't contemplate upon the tawheed, then our understanding of it is deficient. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ. نعم محمد أحسن الله إليك. إلا لوحده. نعم نعم. No, طبعا it's not only a statement of محمد بن الوهاب رحمه الله, but يعني هذا يعني it is ينقل إلى من ابن عباس رضي الله عنه. جزاك الله خيرا. نعم. وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. If there was a mistake that I made, please rectify me. May Allah, the one that is free from any imperfection, rectify in your affairs and grant you the Jannah and allow you to see him يوم القيامة. Allah